Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny. Thanks for joining me today. We're talking about the crow's feet, canthal lines. Those are the lines that are formed by the orbicularis muscle when we contract and smile. They bother a lot of people. It's especially men. That might be their first presentation to a clinic that does injections because it really bothers them and they feel that it ages them. Personally, I don't mind a few lines around the eyes, especially if they're larger folds. That means the skin is good. They can point to other problems. When you see fine lines around the eyes or lines that are ingrained in the skin, meaning at rest, they're still showing, or when people get a tan and you see the lines forming, it means they're probably deeper and it might be something you want to do something about. But we're going to talk about them. I'm going to show you the injections, talk about a few nuances. This is a quick clip. We're getting started in 3 seconds. So one of the most common cosmetic procedures done in the United States and around the world is Botox cosmetic. Also, there's dysport, Xeomin, jeuveau. Watch my video on comparison of all those toxins if you want to know more about which one might be right for you, which one's the strongest, which one has the most active product. But it's such a common procedure. Why? It's because it works quickly. You can be in and out of your physician's office within minutes, and within a day to three, see results. They maximize in about a week to two, and in general, they're gonna last anywhere from 2 to 5 months. Why the variance? Depends upon the amount of muscle movement, if the appropriate dose was done, and everyone wants to do a little less than they should, is very typical, and as well, if there's loss of collagen, then a little tiny bit of movement that comes back are gonna form more lines, especially around the eyes, because they're dynamic lines. Here's the one key factor to consider about lines around the eyes, and I mentioned men typically present with this as one of the first things they wanna get done. For a lot of people, I'll discourage them from doing lines around the eyes if I think what? The skin is good. So if the skin is good, there's no other real lines, I'm not seeing thinning of the skin, I'll give them the option to wait to use topicals and other treatments. However, if they're fine lines, if they're ingrained in the skin, it's showing us loss of collagen. And the key point to remember, neuromodulators like Botox, all they do, this important point, stop muscle movement. They do not make your skin better. They do not build collagen. They do not make it more robust. Why is it then? You're going to say, Rajani, why is it? When I get it done, I have to come in less. It seems like it works and lasts longer the next time I get it. Or I'm only coming in twice a year. It must be making me younger. Well, the reason is it's shrinking the muscle. It's atrophying the muscle, and you have to be careful. Why? Volume in the face makes us look young, as long as it's not too much fat or sagging fat. Baby fat, fat or volume in the right area, is what we pay money for. So there's areas you cannot atrophy. One of them is around the eyes and the temple when you're doing those injections. Let's go watch some injections being done. We'll look also at a before and after picture, and we'll move on from there. We mix it up with a liquid first, so it comes as a powder, and you can watch my video on what's the unit of Botox and is mine diluted. So when you watch the injections here, you're going to see they're fairly superficial. Remember, muscle bleeds. We don't want to bruise or make somebody bleed, because a bruise is just that. It's bleeding underneath the tissue. And placement is oh so important. We start at the top and we work down, because we're trying to get the fibers of the downward orbicularis oculi, or the muscle that moves the brow down. At the edge of the brow is typically where it's found. But remember, not always, because brow shape's different. People get microblading. They do things to their brow, and it can be in different positions. So it's important to look at the anatomical variations, and also the bony orbit gives us an idea of where the muscle should be, not necessarily the brow. It's important what is used, the dilutions used, the pattern. Don't want to atrophy any areas, because you'll get hollows. And remember that fat in the face, as long as it's not sagging or too much, makes us look younger. So we gotta be careful where we atrophy or shrink the muscle, and maintain your collagen, because Botox does not help with collagen production. It does not thicken the skin. And if anything, you can get thinning of the skin given that you've lost some muscle that was plumping it up before. Here you can see a before and after picture of crow's feet. This is using Botox cosmetic. Before, there's some lines and wrinkles, and afterwards, you can see despite smiling, the lines are gone around the eyes, and people like that a lot. So it's important, watch my video Botox Dirty Little Secret so you understand radio frequency, high frequency ultrasound, biostimulators like Sculptra, facial fillers, they all work together. Even PDO threads will build your collagen, so that we're not just taking care of the muscle movement, which is the problem with a lot of this. Tell me, what do you like? What's your favorite product? What's your favorite area to get neurotoxin? For most people, it still is the glabella. Thanks for joining me. Raji's Quickie. Join us next week to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.